Thanks for taking a play with us, folks, here on Shotgun Saturday Night. Are you ready for a little bit of the beast? Here he comes.
The following contest is scheduled for one call with a 20-minute time limit. Approaching the ring from Cold Water, Michigan, weighing 250 pounds.
He's a good manager. He had one, and he screwed that up. But now he's determined to do something about it.
I don't think Dan the Beast Severn was too pleased with his loss at the King of the Ring to The Rock, and of course, D'Lo Brown in that controversial chest protector played a large role in Severn going down. Not to say that The Rock doesn't have the goods to beat Dan Severn. I'm not saying that.
Well, you better say it if you're anywhere close to Dan Severn, because he doesn't believe that The Rock has it. That match was the first loss by pinfall that Dan Severn has ever suffered in his professional wrestling career, and he blames one guy, D'Lo Brown.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. Dan Severn seems to be more motivated and more focused in his dancing with what brung him, as the old cliche goes, and that is a man that can transform from almost a Clark Kent-like out-of-the-ring demeanor into an animal, a beast.
Well, I'll tell you something else. Dan Severn has some weak points. Dan Severn does not deal well with outside interference. Dan Severn is not a longtime wrestling veteran. He's not used to dealing with dirty tricks and cheap tactics. But in a one-on-one contest, in any kind of competition, any kind of hand-to-hand combat, I say there's nobody on earth over the long haul that can take Dan Severn out.
Even Ken Shamrock?
I don't think so.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's a match that the world would like to see at some point in time. Severn and Shamrock, one-on-one. And as unpredictable as the WWF is, you never know when that match is going to happen.
There is so many... Boy, he is hot tonight. There are so many variables in the World Wrestling Federation. So many factions. So many guys to come in and give a helping hand. Severn's not very good with that, to be honest with you. He doesn't know how to handle it yet. He doesn't have the experience. But what he does have is just playing the best wrestling background of any professional today. He's a black belt in karate, a black belt in judo, a black belt in jiu-jitsu. He's a beast. And one-on-one, I don't think anybody can take him.
The sellout crowd enjoying the offensive display thus far of Dan the Beast Severn. Nothing like seeing the WWF live, folks. But tomorrow night, we're going to be in Staples Arena in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Next Saturday night, a huge crowd on hand in Rupp Arena in Lexington, Kentucky. Next Saturday night, live. On Friday night, July 24th, a huge cage match headlines an event in Phoenix, Arizona at the America West Arena next Friday night, July 24th. Not to mention on Monday, July 27th. Oh, that's a suplex and a half. Arrowhead Pond in Anaheim for Raw is War. And I'm especially excited about Tuesday, July 28th in the Sports Arena in San Diego.
Hey, he's got him. He's got him, JR.
This is how D'Lo Brown got his pectoral muscle just ripped from his breastbone by Dan the Beast Severn. And I have been more impressed with this outing of Dan Severn, quite frankly, than all his other matches here in the WWF.